TV show, the best and most unique platform for undiluted information. Showing on NTA Channel 12 with you. Community Report. Health Report. Project Spotlight Report. Fashion and Style. Documentaries. Exclusive interviews. Showing on NTA Channel 12 with you. The Cradle TV Show. Your true platform for development.
Hi there. A very wonderful evening to you out there. And thank you so very much for coming on the Cradle TV Show on NTA Channel 12 Uyo. My name is Dara Olion. And today on the show, we have wonderful speech that will spice up your day. Don't forget that this is to entertain you, inform you, and also to educate you. So we actually played host to Fortune Group of Schools, where the children took turns to display their cultural attires by, you know, highlighting so many countries of the world, the likes of children dressed in an Indian way, England, British, and lots more. So why don't you stay glued to your TV set and enjoy this wonderful piece from Fortune Group of Schools. Don't forget, the Cradle TV Show coming your way on Friday by 6 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. My name still remains Dara Olier.
As part of the effort to expose the fortunate future leaders on the cultural practice of other countries, should in case they travel out of the country, and also to promote, preserve Nigerian rich cultural heritage. Fortune Schools in Uyo, Akwa Ibom State, on Friday, March 13, 2020, staged a day-long cultural activities for the pupils and students of the school.
Asa Fulani versus the Yoruba. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you just joining us, DJ Hode. Already, thank you DJ. For those of you just joining us, it is the 2020 edition.
At this point in time, ladies and gentlemen, let's take the national anthem.
The school cultural day saw the pupils and students dressed in different cultural attires in accordance with the country, state of origin, and ethnic groups which they represented.
This is not just going to be only about Nigerian culture. We've decided to travel out of Nigeria to invite others to come in and also show us their own cultural heritage.
When my
Declaring the event opened, the chairman on the occasion, Mr. Sunday Umana, expressed joy and satisfaction on the turnout of the event, declaring that for the theme of the outing to be successful, all hands must be on deck, as it is not going to be the work of the school alone to achieve unity in diversity.
So I want to appreciate the organizers, the school authority, for deeming it necessary to set a day aside for culture to be celebrated. And I looked at the topmost part of the program and thought about the unity in diversity. It is not going to be the work of the school alone. Just like the preacher had rightly said, the parents also will have a responsibility. If not, the virtues, the norms that we were handed over to our forebears, we will be tempted to take them to the grave without handing over the baton. It doesn't matter where you come from, let's try to tolerate, let's try to coexist. There's a need for us to understand that the other person is as important as our own children.
He called on the parents to contribute their quota towards the Global Unity Project.
To give the message to your child, together everyone will come together and we make Nigeria a better place. If your father wouldn't force the child to become an enemy to his enemy, then the future will be different from what the father has. But anytime we want our children to live exactly the way we have lived, the nation we are going to experience will be exactly the same that we are experiencing. So if we need a change in any aspect of life, I think we should also change the way we deal with our children, both at home and outside. I'm believing, like one of the children that pray said, this festival is for us to have fun. I sincerely believe that we already had fun enough with the talk here and several other ones would make us very happy that we came here. Very importantly, thank you parents for finding time to leave all your busy schedule to support the children. God bless you all.
Similarly, the acting school principal, Mr. Festus Ekwere, while welcoming parents, guardians and visitors to the school, said Fortune School set aside the day to celebrate Nigeria and other foreign rich cultures, as what is good should be taken to greater heights.
I feel elated to welcome you all to Fortune Schools today to celebrate the rich culture of Nigeria, Africa and other continents with our pupils, students, staff and the management of the school. Culture, as we know, refers to the way of life of the people or of groups within the society. The culture, the way of life of the people is expressed in the group's norms, cultures and values, as well as in the shared expression along with language. All these are reflected in the dress pattern, food and eating, dance, song and so on, which we are going to watch our children display today. Every year, thousands of people from all over the world visit Nigeria to witness the beautiful culture, history, and other amazing phenomena which she is blessed with. It is high time we protect what we have in our culture, and whatever is good should be taken to greater heights as Fortune Schools do. We should try to eliminate all those practices which are against human rights, even if they have been practiced in our culture for centuries. At this point, please join Fortune Schools to celebrate Nigeria and other foreign rich cultures by encouraging the pupils and students as they thrill you. Thank you and welcome to Fortune Schools.
Pupils and students group of Igbo, Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani, Efik Ibibio, Scotland, Brazil, India, and South Africa origin were richly and colorfully dressed in their cultural attires, performing their cultural display and serving guests with their well-prepared native foods.
And the step out for your cultural dance.
Welcome, South Africa. DJ, are you ready? South Africa, thank you.
Thank you. You can see the distinguished senator taking the natural wine, and mommy is set. This is Brazilian meal. All right, once we are done with Brazil, we have to move straight to India.
What are they?
Some of the activities displayed include fashion parade, interlude of music, scout presentation by fortune schools, drama competition, tug of war, final contest, cultural dance competition by indigenous groups, food exhibition, foreign cultural dance competition. On his part, the founding chairman of the school, Senator Aloysius Atok, expressed joy on the performance of the school teachers, pupils and students, affirming that the next session planning of the cultural day will begin as he will invite other country representatives to attend the function in a bid to create a global community presence in Fachin schools.
The chairman of this great occasion, all other very distinguished persons at the height of the title of Efiat and my host, the PTA chairman of a school, the commissioner of police being heavily represented here by my brother, and all others, my wonderful parents, and then the beautiful pupils and students of Fortune School System, the management, staff, and students for this great presentation. I'm sure if somebody had looked at me when they were doing the march past, somebody would have seen some drops of tears in my eye. Happiness and a sense of fulfillment from the packaging, the selection of people and students to represent the cultural areas and the other nations, including even the selection of the head teacher to be part of South African group. It looks very, very South African. A session of this cultural day from this year, so that by next year this time, I can assure you that I will bring all the representatives of those countries from all the embassies to be here to see what we are doing. So we must start the planning this year, so that by this time next year, we'll be able to attract all the representatives from those countries. I will send the clips to the different embassies to show them what we've done and to show them why they must be in person to witness what we are doing. That we are creating a global village, a global community from 14 communities, that it is possible for Nigeria to be a community, a single community, that is also possible for the world to be a global village and a global community. So I want to thank all of you who met, whatever input you met, to let us have this wonderful day. I want to thank you very sincerely. I can say without any utter of doubt that you are wonderful parents, and I'm very proud of all of you. You are the best parents any school can hope to have or could have. Therefore, thank you very much. For the teachers, I want to say you've increased my love and respect for you, because you've done wonderfully well. The adaptation of the different cultures, selecting children to get them to be so adapted, looking as if they are actually from those places, it's been a wonderful work you've done. So please receive my thanks once again, the teachers and non-teaching staff who made input into this great day. Then for the pupils and the students, you are, I can tell you, from I sat down here, I've seen news presenters, I've seen television faces, I have seen actors and actresses, I've seen world leaders, I've seen governors, I've seen legislators, and I've seen peacemakers. And therefore, I want to say, you are wonderful gifts of God and wonderful make of nature. I love all of you, and I pray that the Lord will continue to keep you and make you grow to be what the Lord has wanted you to be, especially with what you've done today. So, my children, thank you very, very, very much.
Announcing the results of the competition, the chairman panel of judges, Mrs. Oridola Paul Kanching, declared Indian Cultural Group as the winner of the foreign cultural competition, followed by the Brazilian group with second position, Scotland, third position, and fourth position to South African group.
Our brothers and sisters in the continent, and we are also having four cultures. We have represented Brazil, Scotland, India, and South Africa. The fourth position goes to, with a point of 105, goes to South Africa. Can we please put our hands together for South Africa?
South Africa.
Fourth.
The fourth position goes to South Africa.
And the second runner-up goes to Scotland with a point of 116. Okay. Scotland, please. Can we have a representative from Scotland?
Today it is my pleasure for the 2020 cultural competition of the Fortune School. I want to say that it has been a pleasure to present to the Scotland second runner-up. Today I have the pleasure to do this. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Sean, with a point of 133, goes to Brazil.
Brazil! The first runner-up. The first runner-up, Brazil.
May we invite Mrs. Opem, please?
Put your cap now. Put your crown on your head.
On behalf of us, we wear the pipe and the t-shirts. We're representing this to you.
in the Father and the Holy.
Amen.
Thank you. Congratulations to Brazil. The first round of Best Final.
Namaste, the Indian group. We have 40 points. Can we have the honor of Mr. Adam Moses, please, sir?
Mr. Adam Moses, the head of the Ministry of Culture.
For me to be here, to be the one to present the winner trophy to the winner international India, going to show that the entire world is better, a small community. We thank the Boxing School for doing this, for this exhibition. Congratulations for your win.
Congratulations to the Brazilian for winning in the foreign category. Thank you.
India.
While the Yoruba cultural group emerged first on the indigenous cultural competition groups, seconded by Hausa / Fulani group, Afik Ibibio group took the third position, while the Igbo group came up with the fourth position.
Fortune Committee song.
Yeah.
The chairman, sir, my wife and all others, the Teilong, on behalf of the management and staff of Fortune School System, have a singular privilege of presenting this trophy to the winner of 2020 Cultural Day in Fortune School System. Congratulations and be blessed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. That is the presentation of the overall winner of the 2020 cultural celebration here at Fortune School.
Goodwill messages were acknowledged from dignitaries including the Honorable Commissioner, Ministry of Education, Professor Nse Esien, represented by the Director of Administration in the Ministry, Mr. Ikpe Efion.
Permitting the society that are not accepted, but the good ones, I have observed today, are those things that we can do and add to our culture so that we continue to grow and develop, because culture also helps in development.
The curator, National Commission for Museum and Monuments, Elder Nsebong Ekon.
By this, we have seen the talent in the students, and as so be it, most of them will never depart from this aspect of things they have done. I want to encourage this school, like has been said, the cultural subsector is a part of this program. And we want to say that we will continue to partner with this place in most of the programs that are yet to come. Once again, I want to encourage the management and the chief executive of this place, as per the chairman, to continue with this good work. May God bless you and bless you too, in Jesus' name. Amen.
The head teacher, Fortune International School / Primary School, Mrs. Ndifreke Nduka.
Etenyen Senator Aloshizeto Ndo Edima Wanamo Professor Comfort Eto Mbe Sosoro Kemufodi Songanda Ndo Mendikbe Manankom Mendida Itakukara Ke Fortune Ekodo Moki Kombo Mekbo Management Na Mufoseto Aketie Ekere Nkori Ufongweremi Yagabasidion Mufo Nkom Toyen Kima Amwe Yakidebe Mo Maratore Quebe Mongbo. Ukom Mega. Namufe, etoile d'aille en dit Tomufo. Essentiel moment, yayan yaya, for us your mom, Flemmy. Moi, de dinam yahusoro send Flemmy yaya.
The C Division Divisional Police Officer, Mr. Kayode Adebayo, represented by the DCO, Ezeku Victor.
The chairman and founder of Fortune Schools, the chairman of this great occasion, the traditional rulers, eminent personalities, I welcome you all. I was asked to represent, that my DPO asked me to represent him, because as I'm talking to you now, since morning they have been having series of meetings with the Commissioner of Police. It is a thing of great joy to be in your midst. I want to wish the chairman and founder, and equally, what I saw on display this morning is something that will remain everlasting in my memory. Honestly, it shows that this school is unique. Please give them a rounding applause.
Parents, pupils, and students had a one-on-one talk with the Cradle TV show.
Shining baby. I'm so excited about the event that took place today at Fortune and School. It was so amazing, you know, seeing different cultures. It reminds me of how wealthy the world is at large and how rich the African culture is. So today's event was so amazing. And the children had fun, all of them. I was so happy seeing smiles on their faces, and it was a thing of joy for each and every one of us. Thank you, Fortune School, for arranging such an organizing such an event for the kids and for the parents as well. We are proud of this school. It's a very nice thing. Thank you very much.
I feel good. It's okay. I enjoyed it.
What was your culture?
To South Africa. Yes, I'll be comfortable with everything because your tribe is a wonderful tribe and it's full with good people and they also have a good way of life. Daniel, praise us to the Bobby.
Yeah, sure, absolutely. I think I would certainly say, with what I've seen today, any child from Fortune International School that travels out will be able to fit in. You can imagine, I, for example, I'm a mother of five in the school, and I have all my five children in different cultures. So every day is different, we are at home, and I see the beauty in it. I was so glad they didn't put all my kids in one group because I wouldn't have seen the beauty in other cultures. So I think with this exposure, they are building them psychologically, they're building them to mix internationally. Last year I traveled to South Africa with my children, and this year one of them is in South Africa. I was like, oh mommy, I remember this, I remember the dance, I remember the music. So I think Fortune is doing a great work and I'm glad to be a parent in Fortune. I'm Mrs. Oredola Kwachi.
My name is Ella Bogos. Today was nice, great, and we saw different cultures perform their food and their languages and their dresses. It was a wonderful event. The school did great by organizing this event so that we can know more about other cultures. So when we leave from Akwa Ibom to another culture, we can be able to stay with them.
It's our cultural day, but we needed to
our culture
and no, it's cultural our cultural day, but we had to invite the international cultures to come and celebrate with us. I first of all want to give praise, all praise to God for this day, and having and appreciate my chairman and the proprietors of Fortune Schools. It has been a
Thank you very much for your
Their educated the children, because without them, we would not have had this cultural, beautiful, colorful cultural day.
Mommy and
I am
Daddy.
Mrs. Nifreke
Udoka, the head of our parents here.
It was fun razzmatazz as the pupils of Fortune Group of Schools danced and rejoiced greatly. To God be the glory.
On the Cradle TV show on NTA Channel 12, I want to urge you to stay glued to your TV set next week, same time, same station. For now, bye. Don't look for anybody's trouble. My name still remains Dara Earlier. Bye.